the first time my grandma was given an iPhone. She held it in her hands and said, "Ekie." I said, "Dadi ma, this is an iPhone." So she continues to inspect it in her hands like a ripening mango and eventually decides that it tastes good. Turns out her favorite function was Siri, probably because she sounds familiar. Growing up, I got used to hearing the women in my family repeat phrases like, "Sorry, I didn't get that," or "It's your opinion that counts." There's a reason why the Siri on an iPhone has a woman's voice. She only speaks when spoken to. Just me on a stage is an act of defiance, is a place I am but shouldn't be. When people ask me where I'm from, I respond, "Here." To which they say, "No, but like, where are you from? "Oh, I'm from here. I am from my mother's silence. I am the hyphen between Indian and American, a border splitting myself in half. In America, I am a foreigner. In India, I am a foreigner. My grandfather was a refugee twice. His survival story folded into the layers of his turban. His three sons, terrorists. My mother, the wife of a terrorist, because she is only ever a wife, and my father, only ever a terrorist. When people call my family Al-Qaeda, I forfeit my fuck you to fear. Shut up like they want me to. Tell me, how is this not violence? I am generations of white men fucking their way into my complexion. My hands are flags waving at the same men who conquered me like a country that never intended to belong to them. And isn't that how I lost my voice in the first place? Because and just like that, in 16 syllables, I am a stranger. And if you're not supposed to speak to strangers, and I only speak when spoken to, it's no wonder why getting up in front of a mic feels a lot like breaking through my mother's silence, like the inanimate object in your back pocket finally stopped apologizing. One of Siri's default answers is, who I am is not important. I am important. I'm a revolution rising from underneath the American dream. I am everything that has tried to silence me. I am a wolf howling at a moon that will never howl back at me, which is to say, this country will not answer my prayer. This country does not speak the language of my God. This country would kill my God because she wears a turban. This country is a place I am but am afraid to be. This poem is proof that I am here. When people ask me where I'm from, I will still respond, here. I mean, wasn't Columbus looking for India in the first place?